The African Queen by C.S. Forrester, dramatized for radio by Paul Mendelssohn.
Dear Mr. C.S. Forrester, I do hope you will forgive my writing to you unbidden, but I have to confess that here in Cape Town, I am a devoted, albeit somewhat decrepit reader, of your exciting novels about Captain Hornblower. It is for this reason that I would like to share with you the true story of myself and a gentleman, whom I shall call Charlie Allnut, and an ancient ramshackled hulk called the African Queen. It is quite an adventure story, I can assure you, with surprising twists and turns, and a particular secret, which, as a writer, I feel certain you will enjoy. It began over 20 years ago, in 1915, deep in the forest of German Central Africa, at a Christian mission that my dear brother Samuel had been running with my, hopefully, useful assistance.
Rose. Rose!
Yes, Samuel? What is it? Are you in pain?
There's another. Samuel prayed for victory over the Amalekites. So we must pray now.
Indeed, brother. For what exactly? For the villagers to return? I fear there is no chance of that. Now that General von Hanneken and his army have swept the poor creatures off.
The Lord has always looked favorably on the British Empire, Rose. Now that we're at war, I know that he has little time for the Germans.
But should we not pray to the Lord for you, dear brother? Your health is ebbing, along, it has to be said, with our supplies and reserves. We are completely cut off, ransacked. I fear that I cannot help you.
Please, sister, do not weep. I know that I have failed in my duty. I rely on you, my poor, sweet, innocent girl, to carry on the good Lord's missionary work. You know I shall always be here to protect you.
That night, my sole protector died. Now I was totally alone and unprepared, hating the Germans, and foolishly deep inside, wanting to strike a vengeful blow for poor Samuel.
Hello?
Little did I know that the engineer of my as-yet unformed plans was even now arriving at my door.
Hello? Oh, hello, miss. Where is everybody? Place looks like a ruddy morgue.
And so it should, Mr. Allnut, with my poor brother lying dead inside.
Oh, that's bad, miss. I know he thought of me as unchristian, but I always respected him. I did that.
Thank you, Mr. Allnut.
Didn't like him much, mind. I see the Germans have been here too. I got back with my stores upriver at the mine to find it all deserted. But old von Hanneken ain't got the African Queen. Oh, no. Though I bet he'd like to have what's in it.
And what is that, Mr. Allnut?
Blasting gelignite, miss. 8 boxes. And tin grub and heaps of other things besides.
Mr. Allnut?
Yes, miss?
Will you please bury my brother? I can read the service.
Of course, miss. Glad to. But what are you going to do? Stay here?
Do I have an alternative?
Suppose not.
Well then.
Except...
Except what, Mr. Allnut?
You could always maybe come down river. With me?
With you? On a boat? Alone?
Yes, miss.
I think we had better pray. I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even though he dies, says the Lord. And so, dear Lord, I render unto you the soul of our beloved brother, Samuel Sayre.
I cannot believe to this day that I was prepared to render any part of my own body or soul to the wreck that was the African Queen. She was squat, grubby, and flat-bottomed, not unlike Mr. Allnut, and 30 feet long. Her paint was peeling off, and she absolutely reeked of decay. Again, not unlike Mr. Allnut.
Back there, miss, under the awning. That's the stern. That's where you'll sleep.
Oh, and, where?
See, here, where the old engine and my boiler is. Yeah, we call this a midships. I usually kip around here. But right now, I've got to fill the furnace with fresh wood so we can be on our way.
Oh, yes, please, you do whatever it is that you do, Mr. Allnut. Thank you.
Steam leaked absolutely everywhere, and Mr. Allnut was forever rushing around, peering at gauges, thrusting in more wood, the perspiration pouring off him in rivers. Rather a nice play on words. You may use that if you wish. Meanwhile, I stood on the deck, looking out at all I was about to leave behind.
Excuse me, miss.
Yes, Mr. Allnut?
Can you follow me? Well, I'm thinking we should get somewhere where we can't be seen and, you know, talk about what we could do.
An excellent idea.
Yeah, mind that pipe.
Oh, thank you. Might I perhaps assist in some way?
Oh, well, would you mind very much holding the tiller, miss, so as we can be on our way? That big metal thing just over there?
Very well. Sorry, rather hot.
Yes, would be. That's it. See? The old girl's moving. Now, port a little, miss. Move it over this side. That's it. Port. A little bit too much. Steady now. Ha-ha!
And so we sailed on, away from the only life I had known for so long. But I have to confess, I was soon growing oddly impatient.
Mr. If I might interrupt, Mr. Allnut?
Yes, miss?
Perhaps we should talk now. I mean about whither next.
Whither? Well, we got heaps of grub, miss. 2,000 fags and 3 old cases of gin. We can stay here in one of these little tributaries for months.
I'm speechless, Mr. Allnut.
Knew you'd be pleased.
But what about the Lord's work? Seeking our side to give them the support they need?
Not exactly sure how we'd do that, miss. See, whichever way our side came calling, the Germans would always be between them and us.
Oh, I see. Well, what about the Congo side? Surely if our chaps came from that way...
There's only one way to come from the Congo, miss. And that's across the lake. And nothing can cross the lake while the Louisa's there.
Louisa?
Only a dirty great German police steamer. Only 100-tonner. With her 6-pounder pop gun, the Carnegie Louise rules the waves. That's for sure. If it weren't for her, our lads could get an old Von Anakin, but as it is...
And that is exactly when I had my revelation.
Mr. Allnut, we must do something for England. Don't you agree?
Well, yes, of course, miss. Of course we must, but I'm afraid there's...
This river, the Ulanga, it runs into the lake, doesn't it?
Well, yes, miss, it does, but you ain't going to get there in this launch.
Well, why not?
Rapids, miss. Rocks and dirty great cataracts that'll send you crashing right down. Mangrove swamps.
And that's your opinion, is it?
No, miss. That's a fact.
The dangers may be a fact, Mr. Allnut, but as for our ability to...
And suddenly I heard my dear brother's voice, as loud and clear as if he was still standing right next to me.
Rose, sister... What are you thinking? To question the veracity of a man? Even one as near to heathen as Mr. Allnut? As my premature, albeit God-willed, demise addled your poor feminine brain.
And so I held my tongue and sat sweetly in the stern sheets of the African Queen, trying to suppress the flood of patriotism boiling within me. I lasted all of 5 minutes.
Mr. Allnut? Mr. Allnut?
I'm on the privy, miss. Did you want...
No. I'll talk through the... Mr. Allnut, this blasted gelignite we're carrying. Is it dangerous?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.